watching Fish Tarantulas. Today's video, I have got three rehousings. One is of my Titticockle albipilosum, my Citrogyrus macharlii, and my Nandu chromatis. Let you know now, on the third one, my Nandu chromatis, I try and get her out of the enclosure and she just takes a little bit of a tumble. Didn't think this was going to happen. I'm only telling you now, and I'm only showing this because I know these things happen, and I do try to be as truthful as I can in the issue. He literally felt like it 2 inches. It is a tiny enclosure, but I felt, didn't like it, felt bad about it, because the enclosure she was in, it's got that weird little lip thing that goes around her on the tarantula room ones, and she went, I thought I could get her to go up and over, and she had a little tumble. She's fine, she's perfectly fine, as you'll see in a minute. I just thought I'd give you a heads up now. That's what she did. She had to try to climb and had a little bit of a tumble. So anyway, that is my video, and I hope you like it, and I'll catch you at the end. Bye. Okay, that's video. I did this enclosure for the nightmare before Christmas. I've been trying to decide what to put in it. I have contemplated putting the pumpkin patch back in, but it's a very big enclosure for what she is. So I am going to do an upgrade for Aragog, my Titticockle albipilosum, our very first tarantula we ever had. So I think this little sausage deserves an upgrade.
Yep.
So,
or just a bigger house.
So, my little sweet cheeks, let's get you in here. I'm not worried about you at all, but
tarantulas don't even have the cheeks.
Alright, now, go on.
What?
Come on, beautiful. Come on, sweetheart. Mm-hmm. You're not on me. Mm-hmm. Come on, Tuppence. Come on, not in your hide. Not in your hide.
Don't!
Give me tweezers, come on. Come on, beautiful. Come on. Oh. I have to just take this out. There's so much webbing on here, darling.
How about we transfer the web to the enclosure?
I don't need to transfer the web, but what I am going to do, I'm just going to do it like this. Is that what I'm doing? I'm going to get all of this off. I'm going to get this here. And just try and get them.
Tarantulas don't like to be wet, Mum.
That's right. Okay, can you see what I'm doing?
Yeah.
I've got to try and coax them out. Come on. I've got your beautiful new house and hide. Come on. I'm not a funny angle here. Come on, darling. Come on. Oh, don't butt flip me. Another couple of steps.
One last toe.
And yay. There you go, darling.
Yay.
I've completely just destroyed your water bowl. And your beautiful... Oh, don't flick your bum hairs at me. There's a lovely hide there. And I think you are going to love it in there. So there is Aragog, my Titticockle albipilosum, in her new home. Well, I hope to call it a female. And yeah, hopefully she'll like it in there. Rehousing my Citrogyrus macharlii, my straight horn baboon rainbow unicorn, into this. They are a borrower, so I've given them a little bit more substrate than I did in the previous one. Like I said, this is my daughter's tarantula called Rainbow Unicorn, and because it is called rainbow in her name, we've given her some colourful flowers and some little stones that look like water droplets. I've given her a hide, and I have put some sticks in, so hopefully she will use these as anchor points and kind of web up this area rather than just dig down and never see her again. So she is still quite tiny. I'll show you her in a minute. Anyway, I think she might be about an inch, maybe a bit more. So she could stay where she is, but she's very fast, and I don't want to risk anything once she's molted to lose her or anything like that, because the brat plush she's in it is quite narrow. So I'll put her in here and she can grow up nicely in here. Yeah,
okay.
You on? Okay, my little sweet cheek, as you can see. She's a very nice. She is tiny, but she is quick.
Yeah.
So I'm not expecting to cause me too much fuss, to be honest. Sorry, darling. Made me jump too. But I'm trying to give you a bigger home so you can grow. Not, I know you are getting ready to molt because you've not eaten for ages. She normally is quite a good eater, but she hasn't eaten for a while, so I do think she is pre-molt. She is starting to get her horn. I don't know whether you can see it from there. Maybe if you look through the cup there, Jess. You can see a little bit. What I'll do, I'll try and get her out and see how she does. In all fairness, she's probably going to go straight into that little hide. And I'm on this ready just in case she does decide to do an up and out. So let's see how we get on. I know she looks so tiny to be in here, but like I said, she is due a molt. And I just don't think the brat plus is going to be big enough for her. Can you catch a sight of that horn at all there? Before she completely disappears.
Yeah, I kind of see it.
Yeah, me too. It's right there.
And there you go. Cup is in.
The cup is out, but the tea is in.
There you go. Okay, so rainbow unicorn with a tiny little horn nugget is in. Hope she will grow into that nicely, web it all up, and be happy as Larry. I'm hoping that the idea is, because she's got... Okay, she's coming up. Because she's getting... Oh, hold on. That's so the wrong way. She'll have more space and be a little bit less skittish, because in the brat plus that she was in, she was just doing laps of the place, so... Every time I went anywhere near, so hopefully it's where she's got more space and be a bit more cozy. I'm going to be rehousing today my Nanda Chromatis, my Brazilian red and white, into here. And get her a bit of an upgrade, because she's in this tiny little square thing. And every time I go anywhere near, she's just doing lots of things. And I'm at the point now where I've got to put that on it, because the turny things aren't turning anymore. So this is the setup I have done for her. It is in one of these rubs. I'm not a fan of rubs, but... it's what I've got at the moment, and I'm fast running out of space anyway. So I've given her a water dish, some moss and a hide, and a few little botanicals and things, and see how she gets on. Okay, a little sprout is down there. I'm going to try and remove some of these things first. I'm sorry, darling. That will make it so much easier to actually get to you. Can I have my flower, Tootsie? Because this is just not good for you anymore, is it, hey? Get you a bigger home. And what if I can just get this wood out? I don't even know how big this piece of wood is. It's not too big.
I didn't see and falling to pieces.
Yeah, I know it is. And the stones as well.
That looks so pretty.
Let me get these out. Okay, this isn't going to be... I'm actually wondering if I could just try and get it to come out. No, I can't. The soil's just going to go everywhere. Mm. But my tubs are quite... I'm going to try. See if I can get it to come up and over. Because the problem is, I haven't got a lot of space. Can we catch a cup there? To get the cup into. Can you go up for me? Can you go up for me? I'm going to help you. Are you going to hide under that lip? Okay, that's a really bad idea. Okay, plan number two. I know, sweetheart, you were scared now. I'm going to try and help you up with this. Don't tumble. I can get it up a bit higher, I can actually.
Go on.
I got it out.
It's okay.
No, it's not working because she's just going under that lip. She's just going under that lip and she's going to fall. Do you know what? No, come on, darling. I need to get you back down again. I really don't want her to fall. Let's see if I can do this. I don't know how I'm going to get it out if I do get it in. But... Come on, sweetheart. I need you to go in here. Wiggle room because this flipping lip. Come on.
If you just lose your grip a little bit and just kind of tumbling.
Scared, that's why. I need to get you down. I don't want to do it in case you tumble again. You're so close to just going up and out, but you... She's just completely scrunched up in there. Come on. The thing is, because it's such a small enclosure, this square, I can't... get her out. And I really don't want to just try to turn around and bite me. Obviously.
Shall we cut it in half with a hot knife?
Cut what in half?
The enclosure.
No, Jess. Come on, I need you to come out.
But it could work.
Come on. Oh, this is ridiculous. Come on. She's going to be so angry with me in a minute. Into the cup, please go into the cup. Go into the cup now. Into the cup. Go into the cup.
Come on, sweetheart. I know you're scared. I want this over as fast as much as you do.
Yeah, butt flick.
Don't flick all your beautiful red hairs off. Come on, into the cup. Into the cup. Watch your face, Jessie, because she's flicking these hairs. There you go. You are such a beautiful girl. You were just did so good. You got a nice shot of her? You've just done so good, darling. Eh? Okay, you've got a nice new home now. Your trauma's nearly over. See, I had your best interests at heart. Look, you've got a nice new home. See that scratchy little square thing? Eh? Oh, so I know cute. You're totally snudged up now, aren't you? Eh? You are totally snudged up. Okay, I'm going to leave you alone to chillax a little bit, okay? Mm-hmm. Okay, beautiful girl.
Hi, and we are back. I hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, give it a thumbs up, don't thumbs it down, like, comment, and subscribe. Hit the notification bell so you know when I upload. So, yeah, that is three rehousings done, and I'm out of space. I'm literally out of space for stuff now. So the ones that get smaller and going to get bigger, I don't know what I'm going to do, fair. I'm literally, like, full to busting now. The one enclosure, literally, I just keep on here on top of the tub that I keep all my bits and bobs in. So, yeah, I'm going to have to have a bit of a rejig and sort some stuff out. But, yeah, like I said, but with the little tumble, she is perfectly fine now. I've been keeping an eye on her. She's completely fine. I'd like to show the truth of what happens with being a keeper. And I don't want to just edit all the good stuff. I like to tell you, if it goes bad, I'm going to tell you it's gone bad. So, yeah, anyway, I hope you like the video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.